Well, good afternoon. Welcome to Seattle's Eastside Real Estate Podcast. This podcast is dedicated to living, working, and playing on the East Side. It is Wednesday, February 3rd. I'm your host, Dan Edwards, with the Eastside Real Estate team. We want to thank you for joining us live. If you're joining us on Facebook, please share this, like it, or your comments are welcome on our live stream that we're doing right now. And if you're listening to one of our previous recording ones, please feel free to comment and share as well. You can find those pre-recorded on our website at theeastsiderealestateteam.com. You can find it on Facebook and also on our YouTube channel with the Eastside Real Estate Team. All right. So we would love to hear your feedback, and we'd also love to hear what you want to hear about. All right. And please subscribe. We do have podcasts. You can find those on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, and more. Today, we're going to be welcoming Kathleen Hunter from the Northwest Canine Coalition to meet local adoptable furry friends, pets, dogs specifically. But before we get there, it's time for some real talk. So today, we're going to be discussing how the record low inventory is affecting both buyers and sellers and what it means. So according to the Northwest Multiple, which is our local regional MLS listing service, we are about 2 weeks worth of inventory. What that means is if no new homes come on the market over the next 2 weeks, we will be out of inventory. Now, as I ping some of my friends and realtors around the United States, we're finding that this is not only a King County phenomenon, but this is actually a nationwide, dare I say, crisis. The situation where we have found a tremendous amount of need for housing out there and very limited supply. As I've mentioned in previous podcasts, we have seen a situation where last year, 2019, we actually had 40% less inventory and still high demand with low interest rates. Now, what I thought I'd do today is break it down, like, what does it mean for buyers and sellers? So I'll start with buyers. First, what it does mean is your barrier to entry is really, first off, it's low because affordability is so high. So let's just talk about that first. The amount, the cost of money is right around 2.75 to 3%, depending on your financial situation, your credit score, and about 30 other factors, how much down payment you're putting. But it actually is interesting to see how much more affordable homes are. And that's driving a lot of people to the market. So in addition to interest rates being low, that's great for buyers, but the challenge is they're low for everybody. And so there's a lot of competition. There's this urbanization where people are deciding to get out of the city, or suburbanization. I should actually rephrase that. Suburbanization, where people are looking to get out of the city to get a little more elbow room. The pandemic has caused that. So buyers really need to get themselves, number one, pre-approved, not pre-qualified, not talk to their banker, not ran a calculator on a website, but get pre-approved. Now, you may not be ready for a month, 2 months, 3 months, or 4 months, or even 12. However, your opportunities are going to be few and far between. So it's better to be prepared sooner than later. So get yourself pre-approved. Also be ready to compete. Now, it doesn't sound great to compete in a market for a house. It sounds like you're going to lose. However, because of this low inventory and no real quick exit of this low inventory situation, you will make this up on appreciation over the next few years. Okay. If you plan on buying and selling in 6 months, not a great plan. But if you plan on buying and sticking around for 2, 3, or maybe 5+ years, you're going to see that money come back, and you got to live somewhere. So buyers, you need to be prepared to compete to find your little piece of home, a place that you can call home. What does it mean for sellers? Well, it means the sellers are kind of in charge. Now, I want to put this clearly, is while they're in charge, they can't be irrational. And what I mean by that is you don't just put any price, because quite honestly, the buyers already have a mentality that they don't want to overpay for a home. So get yourself a great real estate agent to give you some advice on how to strategically price your house. Here's a good example. If you had something really valuable to sell, would you rather have one party to negotiate with or many? I hear you saying many out there, right? So it's always better to have more people to negotiate because you can work them against each other. Now, if you take something that, say, is, let's say I had a stock
Microsoft. I don't know what Microsoft's trading at. Maybe, I don't know, it's 400. I don't know where it's at. I don't watch them. But let's just say, I do know GameStop. Let's use that one. GameStop's, right, is at $400, right? Let's just say, right, that there wasn't this craziness going on. Would you pay $400 for GameStop right now? Probably not, because its assets don't really match it. Now, we have an artificial thing happening with regards to GameStop that's creating a huge amount of demand for it, thus driving the price up. I don't know where it's at now, but you get the idea. As a seller, you have to be within the realm of value. So again, get a good real estate agent to help you position that property so that you can actually have multiple potential bidders, which gives you even more leverage than you already have. Okay. So that's our quick Real Talk segment. We're talking a lot about some of those factors that are happening right now. The bottom line is this: a housing market is going to remain strong throughout 2021. Know exactly what it means for you, whether you're buying or selling. That's my advice. All right. That concludes our Real Talk segment. If you're interested in this and other topics, please check them out on our blog at theeastsiderealestateteam.com/blog. If you'd like to talk to us directly about any of your real estate needs, feel free to contact us directly at 425-200-4093. We thank you for listening. Up next, we have our Paw of the Month segment with the Northwest Canine Coalition. Kathleen Hunter is going to be joining us right after this short commercial break. So, do you get frustrated at how hard life can be? Sometimes, you know, perhaps it doesn't have to be. There's a way to spend your days moving forward instead of digging out from under, especially if you remember to bring your intuition to work. Otherwise, it's like having half a brain in the car. Mary Gleason, executive intuition coach, wants to help you tap into your intuition more deeply and more often to help guide you and guide your decisions that are more fully considered and for your greatest good. Here's what one of Mary's clients had to say. Mary's talents and abilities have surprised me every time. Her corporate background has made it possible for her to help me acknowledge my intuition when it comes to making decisions with my own small business. I find her invaluable. Find out more about this and other offerings at her website, marygleasonconsulting.com, or contact her at mary@marygleasonconsulting.com. That's marygleasonconsulting.com or mary@marygleasonconsulting.com. All right, we're back to the show, and I'm really excited. This is going to be a regular monthly segment, and it's always a fan favorite. It's my favorite. Welcome back to the podcast. I've got Kathleen Hunter with the Northwest Canine Coalition to meet our February Paw of the Month. Our goal here is to share the incredible work that the NWCC and highlight local pups each month in need of a forever home. Kathleen Hunter is the founder and executive director of the Northwest Canine Coalition. While volunteering in the world of dog rescue, she saw the need for their media support for the smaller rescues and shelters and their adorable adoptable dogs. Kathleen took her experience in education and started NW Canine Coalition, which is a 501c3 nonprofit organization. Their mission is to promote the adoption of dogs into loving homes by producing media segments highlighting small Northwest-based shelters, rescues, and fosters. They're also a partner with canine professionals to help make that adoption successful for everyone from the first paws going forward. Thanks, Kathleen, for joining us today.
Hi, thank you for having me.
So, Kathleen, you're going to put up a presentation for us all to see, yeah?
Yeah, are you ready?
Who do you got with us today?
We have, these are our pups. Can you see them?
Not yet.
Sharing.
Bingo.
There we go. Okay, so we have three dogs today that we're going to share from two different rescues. And the first one is Sully. He's a cute little boy. Can you see him?
I think you want to hit your arrow key. Oh. There you go. There's Sully.
So this is Sully. He's outside at a training facility where he likes to learn the agility course. He is with our partner rescue, Lucky Paws Rescue. They're out of Tacoma. He is a 7-year-old Labrador Golden Retriever. He has a little bit of separation anxiety, so he would prefer a family who is home more often than not. However, he is crate trained, so if you do need to step out, he's comfortable staying in his crate. He would like to spend every hour with his family. So I can't blame him, right? He's smart. He enjoys mental activities. So whether it's treat puzzles or extra training sessions. And he also loves, like I said, the agility course. So that physical activity. look at that smile. Oh my gosh. Right? And
I love that nose.
I know, right? I actually got to meet him when we produced his video, and he's such a sweetheart. He does have some allergies, so keep that in mind. He'll need a special diet, but he's working with that, getting that under control. He loves his belly rubs, lots of pets. He enjoys going for long walks, chilling on his bed, as you can see here. And also, Sully's trainer, his current trainer, will provide some complimentary training sessions for his new adopter to help make that transition successful for everyone. And a special note about Sully is that he is losing his foster home by February 14th. If you're thinking you would love to have a dog in the home, but maybe you can't adopt for whatever reason or no reason, consider fostering. It's a great opportunity to kind of test it out for yourself and your family and your home. But you give this puppy a home to live in while he waits for his forever home. So he's in big need of a new home right now. Okay. So that's Sully with Lucky Paws. Our second dog is Bentley, and she is with our partner rescue Must Love Boxers. However, she's not a boxer. She's a little pity mix, but she came in to the rescue with some boxers. So Must Love Boxers and all the rescues out there, they can't say no. And how could you say no to this cute little face? So they have her, and she's looking for her new home. She's adorable. Lots of energy, would love to go on walks, riding in the car. She likes to go shopping. If you watch her video on our YouTube channel, I took her to a hardware store around the holidays, and she shopped for some gifts. We went to a coffee shop and had puppuccinos. So she's somebody who can go with you and wants to go on those trips with you. She does need a yard with a fence so that she can run around and play. But at the end of the day, she wants to cuddle with you and chillax on the couch, maybe catch up on some binge watching. Her favorite things to do are chasing birds and squirrels because it's all a fun game to her. Let's see. So that's Bentley. She's with Must Love Boxers. She's a three-year-old. She's also 3 years old, and she's about 45 pounds. So not too big and not one of those little tiny ones that you can put in your purse, but really good size, little compact size, adorable, adorable little one.
Oh, that's fantastic. So who's next?
Our next one is Thor. Thor is, he has a really soft spot in my heart. He is also with our partner rescue, Lucky Paws Rescue. And Thor is a yellow Labrador retriever. He's just over 2 years old. And in his short lifespan, he's had some challenges. In his previous home, he had cataracts that were neglected, and then those turned into glaucoma. And if you're familiar with that, it's very painful and causes a lot of pressure around his head. So he had both eyes removed, and it sounds horrible and traumatic, but actually it was the best thing for him because now he is running around, he's playing, he loves cheese pudding. With his sticks, playing with his toys, and his mapping skills are impeccable. And what that is he learns his perimeter and his parameters very quickly. So moving into a new home, he's gonna adjust quickly. When we were out there producing his video, it was pouring down rain, and we had our tent out there. And I was saying this to Dan earlier, Thor figured out the perimeter of our tent. So if he was underneath, it was dry, and if he stepped out of it, he's like, oh, it's wet, and he would come back in under the tent. It was really cool to watch. In a short amount of time, he figured that out.
And amazing. So I can tell you that if my daughter is watching this right now, she might be sobbing because she has such a big heart for pups that if it was up to her, we would have all three of these dogs here. Thor.
Thor, he's a really special pup. He has just needs a yard and someone with a place in their heart to take him in. He doesn't travel light. I'll let you know, he will come with his crate, his bed. He uses a ramp to get in and out of cars. Mm-hmm. He has his treat puzzles that he likes to use to keep himself mentally active also. So he's a good sized dog though. He's about 100 pounds, but a real love bug. He'll lean into you. So
that's awesome.
So those are our three dogs. We have Sully from Lucky Paws Rescue, Bentley, the Pity Mix from Must Love Boxers, and Thor, also from Lucky Paws. And one more shout out for Sully, at least the foster home.
Yes, it's that something soon. So the next week, if you want to take Sully for a test drive for a week, maybe 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks, hey, maybe it turns in forever. How does somebody find out about that from you, Kathleen?
Yes, you can go to our website at wk9coalition.org. And all of these dogs are on our website. They have their videos, so you get to watch their videos. You can click on the logo for their rescue, and that's where you can fill out your adoption applications or foster applications online, and everything is sent through online. If you have any, you know, computer issues or you don't want to deal with the online thing, just give me a call. I'll walk you through it. My number is also on our website, but I'll give it to you. It's 425-829-5712. More than happy to help facilitate that process to help these dogs get the homes that they really need.
Kathleen, it's always good to have you. So how many dogs are you highlighting each week?
I think last month I said about 5 to 7 a week, and the number's going up. Wow. So we'll try to feature 2 dogs a day on all our social media platforms.
Okay. So, now, how does a small rescue or shelter become a partner with the Northwest Canine Coalition?
They also reach out to me, email, phone call. You need to be a 501c3 also. We cater to the smaller rescues and shelters in the Pacific Northwest. So if you're a big conglomerate, not to say that we won't work with you, but it looks a little different. But if you're a small rescue, have dogs that need homes, reach out to me, and we'll see what we can do to help shine a light on the dogs in your care.
Awesome. So beside adopting these dogs, what else can our listeners or viewers do to help out the Northwest Canine Coalition?
We need volunteers to help on the productions of our videos. That's a big part of what we do. It's like our meat and potatoes, producing the videos for these dogs so that we can put them out on our social media platforms. That's, you know, if you want to work with the dogs directly. We also need admin help, fundraising, coordinating all the events that we have planned, and fosters for these dogs too. I know that our partner rescues need fosters to foster the dogs. There's a list on our website of areas where we could use your help. Also, don't forget the donate button. We always want to make sure that gets a visit regularly, and that helps us because we don't charge anything to our partner rescues to produce any of the videos or promote their dogs. So it's all fundraising.
Awesome. Well, this is my favorite segment of the month. I love the work that you and your organization are doing. And so thank you so much for coming on. We look forward to seeing you next month.
Thank you for having me.
Sully is an active 7-year-old Labrador Golden Retriever with low to moderate exercise needs. He gets some anxiety when left alone, but does well being crated. His preference is to live with a family who is home more often than not. And who wouldn't want to spend every hour with this handsome boy? Sully is still building his leash skills, but follows guidance well. Like we said, he's smart. Sully loves belly rubs and pets once he knows you, and offers a lot of companionship. As you can see, he enjoys physical activities like learning and mastering the agility course. Look at him go! Sully does have a high prey drive and low patience for boisterous dogs. So he would do best in a calm home where he is the only dog and no cats. Sully is a confident pup, but he does need a little extra time and patience when meeting new people before he feels comfortable sharing his space. Sully has severe allergies to both food and the environment. His new family will be able to maintain his nutritional and physical health needs, but he's worth every penny. Sully is smart and enjoys mental activities like treat puzzles and learning new training cues. He enjoys long walks and chilling in his bed. Sully's trainer will provide some complimentary training to ensure he adjusts well in his new home. Now that's a recipe for success, with all paws going forward.
It was so cold that morning, I almost started running the agility course with Sully just to stay warm. But as you can see, it didn't bother him one bit. If you would like to know how you could join in on the fun with Sully, you can go to our website, nwk9coalition.org, click on the logo for Lucky Paws Rescue, fill out an adoption application, and who knows, you could be the lucky person to run the agility course, run through muddy fields, and have all sorts of fun with Sully together. Thanks for watching. I'm Kathleen with Northwest Canine Coalition. Today we get to shine a light on this little cutie pie. Her name is Bentley. She is with our partner rescue, Must Love Boxers. However, this little one, is a pity mix. And so you might be saying, well, wait a minute, why is she with Must Love Boxers? Because she was rescued with a boxer, and like with all rescues, they don't turn anyone away. One of the fun things that Bentley likes to do is go to the hardware store for some DIY projects. Hey, you. Hey, sweetie, that's you. Hi. Hey, buddy. There you go. Yeah. So she heard hardware store, and we are ready to go. So we're at Ace Hardware. We're going to go shopping. So come and join us, right? Bentley is a 3-year-old medium-sized pit bull mix. She's house trained and also knows how to sit, but she would really enjoy learning some new training cues with her new family. Bentley is a real people pleaser. In fact, her biggest fear is disappointing her forever mama, whoever that might be. Bentley is shy at first, but once she warms up to you, you'll learn very quickly that she's a high-energy lady who is obsessed with cuddles. She'll try to be in your lap at all times, and you'll know you've bonded when she shows you her belly to rub. And she'll give you sloppy kisses. Although she's crate-trained, she does prefer to be with her humans when possible. Except if there are other people coming over who maybe have kids or other dogs, then she'd rather to be in the comfort of her own crate. And she would prefer to be the only dog in her forever home. Besides, who wants to share all the love and affection when you can have it all to yourself? Bentley loves her car rides too, so don't hesitate to take her with you to low-key places like walks and your local home improvement store and coffee shops. Bentley loves the single ladies. But if there is a guy in the house, you'll just need to be a little bit more patient with her, but in time and in small doses of exposure, she will learn to accept him. Due to her anxiety, she can be a little shy and a little scared and vocal at first, but she'll warm up to you and your guests once she is no longer overwhelmed. Ultimately, Bentley is a social butterfly who loves people. Bentley and I just had a very successful shopping trip at the Ace Hardware here in Everett, and now we are going to go to the coffee shop for a treat, like a puppuccino and maybe some cookies. So let's go. Come on, Bentley. It doesn't get much better than this. Okay, look. Are you ready to order?
Hi.
Hi. This cutie patootie would like to order a puppuccino. Her name is Bentley.
Hi, Bentley.
And I would like a dark chocolate mocha with lavender and whipped cream.
Awesome.
All right, anything else, Bentley? Anything else? Do you have cookies?
We do.
Okay, so can't deny her the cookies.
Hey, awesome. Sweetie. I'll be right back.
So we'll have a seat over here.
Okay.
Thank you. Hey, Bentley, this has been so much fun to spend the afternoon with you, going to the hardware store for some little DIY project shopping, and then coming to Rock City Coffee Company for the most fabulous treats for puppies and people. And if you would like to be the lucky person to have these excursions with Bentley, you can go to our website, nwk9coalition.org, click on the logo for Must Love Boxers,
read her bio and fill out an online adoption application. And who knows, come here, Bentley. You and Bentley can be new best friends. Hi, sweetie. Thanks for the fun afternoon. Mwah.
Hi, I'm Kathleen with Northwest Canine Coalition. Today we travel to Lacey, Washington to shine a light on Thor. He's a 2-year-old yellow lab and he's in foster care with our partner rescue, Lucky Paws Rescue. Now in some circles, Thor would be considered a pup with special needs, but after spending the afternoon with him, we decided he's a pup with special qualities. Let's watch.
Thor is with our partner rescue, Lucky Paws Rescue. He is a 2-year-old yellow lab, and he has a very special quality about him. He had surgery to remove both his eyes, and that's because when he was a baby pup, he had cataracts, and then his treatment was neglected and turned into glaucoma, which is very painful. So just in December, he had the surgery to remove both his eyes, which is actually a good thing for him. He's no longer in pain. He has learned his mapping skills, and as you can see, he loves playing with toys. So we're gonna get to know Thor a little bit more and how you can maybe be his new best friend. Hi, Thor. Hey, buddy.
Ideally, Thor's new home will be one where he's the only dog in the house. And if there are children, they should be dog savvy, maybe 6 years or older. And that's only because Thor is a large pup and he's still learning some of his mapping skills, and we don't want the little tiny ones to get knocked over. In his foster home, his favorite person happens to be the 15-year-old teen. So he does get along great with people. He loves his people, and if he could be with his people more often than not, he would be the happiest pup. Thor is very smart, and he's treat motivated. He knows his basic cues, like sit and down and come. He knows his name, and he would love to learn more cues. He's really quick at learning new territory. The thing with him today, he learned the perimeters of our tent, and he was learning that if he walked outside of the tent, it was wet, and if he stayed within a certain perimeter, it was dry.
Thor lives for belly rubs. His first favorite thing is belly rubs. His second favorite thing is belly rubs. And guess what his third favorite thing is? Belly rubs. Thor is crate trained and he's house trained. In fact, even though he's tall enough to reach the counter, he is such a gentleman that he will walk away. He leaves everything in its place. He knows to only chew on his designated toys. He will let you know when he needs to go outside and take care of business. And he also knows that he needs to leave his outside toys outside and his inside toys inside. His world is still new for him. So he's learning how to ride in the car, go places outside of his comfort zone of his home and his yard. As a puppy, a few things were neglected in Thor's care, and one of those things besides his eye care was learning the basics like walking on a leash and wearing a harness. But he's learning now in his foster home, and because he is treat motivated and he's very smart, he is grasping it quickly. He'll need a new family though who's going to continue that training with him. If you're the lucky person who gets to adopt Thor, keep in mind that he doesn't travel light. He's gonna come with all of his necessities, such as a ramp to get in and out of the car, his bed, his favorite toys, a crate, and his food puzzle. But he'll have everything he needs to have his new adoption successful with all paws going forward for everyone.
We had so much fun spending the afternoon with Thor in the soggy, rainy Northwest, and his mapping skills are spot on. If you would like to learn more about Thor, you can go to our website, nwcaninecoalition.org, click on the logo for Lucky Paws Rescue, fill out an adoption application, and who knows, you and Thor could be new best friends. Thanks for watching.
All right, next up, we're going to have Erica Mears, our broker partner, joining us for the Stump the Broker segment. Good afternoon, Erica. Are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
All right. So what have you got for me today? I'm expecting to get stumped here. No softball questions. No telling me how great the team is. I need some good hardball question here.
Okay. That is about appraisal.
Uh-huh.
What are some appraisal issues you might go through with VA loan versus conventional loan on these days?
Well, great question. Now, a loan situation is one where I would encourage everybody to talk to a loan officer directly, but I can speak to this as we definitely have gone through the process many times. One of the benefits that are provided to veterans out there is a VA loan. And a VA loan is a real incentive, and it's fantastic. It's zero down payment. So as a veteran, you basically get a VA certificate, and that allows you the ability to go out and buy a home. You can qualify for the payment, you can get it. So you don't need to have a down payment. What's even better about these loans is they protect veterans from having to go forward. So Erica was asking about an appraisal issue. So let's say you came across a property that you really liked, and in this competitive market, the home was bid up and you accepted that offer on that home. Now, if you just write the contract as written and you don't, there are no extra specific issues with regards to earnest money, you're protected as a veteran. You don't actually have to be compelled if the price comes in lower than the contract price. So that can happen in a market where home prices are rising. So nice try trying to stump me, but here's what I would say is the VA process is one that you're gonna find a really great lender. We've got some great partners that we can introduce you to. And the conventional loan process versus the VA loan process, it's not going to allow you to get a property, to get a loan on a property. This gets a little more complicated, but let's put it this way. So a conventional loan process is probably 3 to 5% down. And if you go 3 to 5% down and the value comes in lower, well, that means you have to make up the difference. In a VA loan, you don't have to make up the difference, and you can walk away and get your earnest money. So there are some things that are different there. So I don't know. Does that help?
Yeah. Was that a little harder?
Well, it's a little harder, a little more nuanced. And I'm happy to refer anybody to one of our fabulous lenders if they're thinking about buying a home and they're a veteran and would like to look into their VA benefits. So thanks for that question, Eric.
And how about you send some buyers to your fabulous buyer's agent?
Yeah, we'll see about that. All right. Thanks for the question. Well, listen. All right.
Sure.
Okay. So in conclusion, we just want to thank everybody for joining. Oh, I did want to point out, I went out today and took a look at a little lake in Renton called Lake Desire. Any of you know of it? I'd love to hear anybody that lives by there, but I found the boat launch there. Now, you can't have powered boats, but you can have electric boats. And if you look at our social media, I'll post a few pictures of that neighborhood. We may have a listing coming up in that area. I was out there talking to a prospective seller about a home. So if you're interested in the Lake Desire area, let us know. We'll connect you. But thanks for joining us. Again, this is the Seattle's Eastside Real Estate Podcast, and it is dedicated to learning about living, loving, working, playing on the East Side. Thanks for joining us. And if you have any real estate related questions, give us a call at 425-200-4093. Thank you so much for watching us. And Kathleen, thanks for coming on. Erica, thanks for your great question.
Sure. Thank you.
You guys have a good day.
You too.